Right, so I've about an hour before Jaden gets back. I've kind of been doing a little bit in here. The album I said I was going to go through was Hysteria. And it's kind of all over the place, obviously. I'm kind of going through it by ear and picking out small pieces. Obviously the first few songs, Women and Rocket, there's actually very little guitar in them. Now I haven't touched solos or anything like that. I'll sweep back at that at the end. Or if there's any interesting kind of things between that, I'll kind of practice them or whatever. But I hope to just have this entire album just note for note, as good as I can get it. A huge thing about that album is the guitar sound, you know. You just can't get it with this kind of conventional kind of setup. You know, majority of that album was recorded DI'd. So, what I'm thinking of, and I've seen a couple of videos on guitar sounds for that album, and I've seen one really good set of videos from a guy who does the Line 6 Helix stuff. So the Helix pedal board would be absolutely ideal for recording along with this, you know. I hopefully just want to do a series of videos at some stage next year where I just go through every song from this album. I'll probably get fucking pulled over anyway, but I don't even know if I can show some of this while I'm practicing it, you know, because I'll probably get a copyright strike for having their music there. So I'll probably have to do everything, just without the, just me doing it solo, not with a recorder in the background, you know. With a lot of that stuff won't even make sense then. But that's just the way it is. I'm not going to risk a copyright strike because I already got two so far, from playing the bass line from that David Bowie song from, I don't know, like 100 vlogs back. And then I got another one for something else. I played something else as well, and I got a fucking strike for that too. I actually don't know what's going to happen with YouTube. I seen an email thing that they've sent around, and it's left very wide open. To be honest, it looks like it's just they're going to clear out any channels that aren't getting views, and any channels that are not generating, you know, that are not doing anything, you know, that are not monetized and not generating views. They're just going to have a broad sweep and delete them, especially if there's any phrases or anything to do with, you know, politics or even mentions of right-wing stuff, you know what I mean? Like, it's gone insane. I'm probably just after adding more weight to my channel being deleted by just even saying that. Their algorithms can pick up everything. So I don't even know. In like 2 months' time, there mightn't even be a YouTube channel. It's just, it's gone crazy. Nobody knows what's going on. And when this European thing kicks in, you know, this these articles that the European courts are after pushing through, and nobody did anything about it. Only a handful of people. I probably won't even be able to show that logo on the thing, because it'll actually, you know, block everything. It's gone beyond a joke. I won't even be able to play any of the riffs away from the album, because I'll get copyright strikes straight away. You know, like, it's insane. It's insane. And like, this channel has like fucking, what, like fucking 6 subscribers. Like, you know, I know the channel has like 80 or 90 subscribers, but sure, like 80 of them are not even in use anymore. They're actually not subscribers. Like, they're from 10 years ago. They're from 12 years ago, 2006, you know. Most of the channels are dead. They're gone, closed and gotten rid of. Like I said, I'm not doing this for fucking views. I'm not doing it for subscribers. I'm doing it as a kind of a, you know, recording the journey along the way. The journey, I don't know where we're going, but sure, you know, it's something. Somebody can look back at it in years to come and say, oh yeah, that's what he was at. Okay, fair enough, you know. So everything is up in the air. I'm not sure what's going on. I'm back on the vape again. Literally because I've no money to buy cigarettes. really need to quit big time. I can't smoke that too much because if I do, I'll start getting that palpitation stuff again. You know, it's silly. If somebody looking at this that doesn't smoke, probably saying to himself, what's he doing? You know, why doesn't he just fucking stop? Like, it's impossible. It's not impossible. I'm in a position right now where I can't. There's so many things going on that I'm just stressed the fuck out, to be honest, and I can't really do anything about it. I'm not been let do anything about it. I'm not been given the chance to let things settle down. It's all over the place.
All right. Still playing away at that. I do want to record some of it at some stage. We needed to get a new cooker. The old one is kind of fucked. The door is not closing on it properly anymore. You can see the way it's kind of, you know, because the door is not closing right. Anyway, the guy coming to do that later. Well, hello there. What are you up to?
What's that?
What's what?
That on your pocket.
That is the Zoom.
Why do you have the Zoom for?
Because the Zoom records audio to that little mic.
Yeah. Daddy, can I put it on the keyboard?
Later. Later.
I'm just going to listen to some music, right?
You listen to music, are you?
Just on the keyboard, can I?
Yeah, we can. We'll do it in a while, all right?
Okay. Can you just do the keyboard now?
Not right now, because I have a few things to do first. And then we'll do it, okay?
Okay.
You can give me a hand to do some stuff. Is that alright? Oh, don't tear that! Don't tear that, that's Craig's box. That's the box from his DVD, Jen. That's his Family Guy box. You can't tear pieces off it.
And my toast back?
It's back because you didn't eat it. It's back to haunt you. That's what happens. Yeah?
I'm hungry.
Did you eat your lunch today?
Can I have my yogurts?
Well, if you didn't eat them, you can have them now, yeah? Yeah, okay, I'll get them for you. Anyway, job is never finished. I've actually been looking up the new GoPro 8s, and I have to say, they look pretty sweet. This can be very jerky when you're moving around. Like I said before, I'm constantly moving around like this, and it's very jarring to look at because I'm only shooting in 30 frames a second. Instead of the 60 frames a second, which would make it smooth. It's just my computer can't deal with 60 frames a second at the moment. I wonder if updating the RAM on that would allow me to get maybe a little bit more out of it. I don't know. I need to look into it. I'll look into it. Anyway, hopefully we'll get back in a while and see what we're doing in here. Okay.
Okay, we've reached the end of the week. It was nice to get back playing a bit, but I did struggle coming up to the end of this week. As you know, these videos go from a Sunday to a Saturday, and we're on Saturday night now. I have to say, tonight and yesterday was a bit of a struggle. I did record a little bit of those songs that I'm trying to cover, because I can't play along with the song because I'll get a copyright strike on the video, obviously. And the songs are very sparse for guitar. The first two songs on that album are pretty sparse for guitar. There's nothing really definitive in there. There are a couple of cool parts and all that, but out of context they sound stupid. Do you know what I mean? You really need to be playing along with the track to get the full thing with it anyway. Anyway, I've kind of gone a preliminary kind of run over them, where I've kind of picked out the most prominent guitar parts. You know, there's a lot of hidden guitar parts that I've noticed when I listen to it in that program I have. I can't even think of the name of it now. I'll think of it in a minute. I'll write it down here, whatever the name of the program is. But anyway, I'm just going with the main guitar parts to try and get them into my head. I didn't look at solos or anything like that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to run through the entire album first, a kind of a preliminary run through, pick out any of the main guitar parts, and if there's any kind of secondary ones I want to kind of work on as well. There are so many layers on that album, it's crazy. You could be going at this for months, but I'm not going to do that. I want to have more or less two separate guitar tracks that will cover everything, you know, a guitar kind of pan left and right. And when I do run-throughs of all of those songs, actually I might actually make videos, I am going to make videos of each song, you know, running through each of them with two guitar parts. Yeah, anyway, that's what the plan is, but that's months away, you know. I just have to work my way through it. I could be tempted to sit down and, you know, look at YouTube you know, I'm probably sure there's probably guitar lessons on the songs, like, but it defeats the purpose. It defeats the purpose of doing that, because I'm not using my fucking ears, like, and my ears are what I need to use, you know. So I want to sit down and actually work this out properly myself, you know. I'm going to get some of it wrong, but by the time it comes to recording, that kind of thing, I'm sure I'll have any of those parts kind of worked out, you know. Could be playing certain rhythm parts wrong because I'm hearing other things. I haven't really isolated the guitar tracks properly yet. I even had a quick run through with them. But yeah, no, it's going to be fun. I'm enjoying what I've done so far anyway. I'm just sorry I can't really play any of the parts in context on the videos, which is really fucking stupid, like. But I'm going to do it anyway when I'm going to record the videos. So where do I have to put them on, Vimeo or some fucking place? I don't know. Like I said earlier, anyway, that we don't know if there's even going to be a YouTube channel in the next couple of months, like, because, you know, they want to get rid of a lot of crap that's on there, like, you know. And I guess any channel that's not gaining views and stuff, instead of just leaving them be, like, for other people, they're fucking going to get rid of them, like. Like I did say before, this is not for like loads of views and stuff, and I want to leave something, you know, for somebody to look at in years to come, like, you know. That's what the plan was anyway. That's all it ever was to be anyway. Right, I'm going to leave it at that. I've waffled too much. Yeah, look, I'm struggling still, but I'm not as bad as I was. Although the last two days seem to be just as bad, if not fucking worse, than what it was over the last couple of weeks. But I know as soon as I sit down and pick up that guitar, it instantly puts me in a better mood, like, you know. So it's easy to keep doing it, especially when you're kind of figuring the stuff out and slowly getting through it. Like that album means so much to me, like, that it's almost in my head that it's, you know, like, unplayable kind of stuff, you know.
I don't know if you ever get that with an album that you've listened to. You know, I suppose I got it because Porno Graffiti, Extreme's album Porno Graffiti, is kind of an album like that for me. It's really, really important. And of course, the guitar playing in that. I remember at the time I managed to buy this tab book for Porno Graffiti. And of course, it's kind of infamous now for being like horribly wrong. And there was like, you know, finger stretches of like 11 frets and stuff like that in the tab book. And I remember coming across that and thinking, oh, that's it. I'll never be able to play that kind of thing. But yeah, I do want to work on some Extreme stuff as well. I have a couple of songs that I want to put aside. Like Cupid's Dead is especially one of them. I want to, some amazing rhythm in that. You know, but I just want to get this Def Leppard album kind of out of the way. And I'm going to go through some of the albums that were like really important to me. Actually, I think I should sit down and try and glean as much as I can out of them. You know, because it's originally what started me at it in the first place. Anyway, this album, Hysteria, another one on the cards anyway, is definitely Poison. I can't even think of the name of the album. I'll put a cover of it here. That album, I'm saying it's a really important album to me, and I can't even remember the name of it. Yeah, we'll leave those two anyway at the moment. But yeah, there's a few more. I must actually sit down and do a video about that. The important stuff that I did listen to, and the important stuff that I feel that if I was able to play, I'd be happy with my playing, you know. Right, I've definitely waffled too long. I'm 7 minutes into this now. Right, it's long enough already. Okay, so we'll see how we get on next week.